The world loves Netflix, and I'm sure you do too. Just some months ago, it would not be out of place to say every rugby player enjoys watching Netflix. But right now, it might be difficult to tell which rugby player loves Netflix and who doesn't. This might be shocking, but if you're aware of Netflix's new Six Nation documentary, it becomes easy to understand why some rugby stars might not be so comfortable with Netflix. You see, Netflix might be strongly associated with movies, but that's not all this organization is known for. Since coming into the limelight, Netflix has put out a couple of documentaries, and one of them is a documentary on what goes on behind the scenes in the rugby world. This 8-episode documentary seems great to the average person, but the rugby world doesn't seem so pleased. You might never understand this if you don't play rugby. However, you will find out why in a moment. In the meantime, please like and share this video. Also, subscribe to this channel to avoid missing our other videos. Let's go on. Rugby fans who've seen this documentary have most likely gotten answers to questions on their minds in regards to what goes on behind the scenes. Unfortunately, the same cannot be said about rugby stars. The Six Nation documentary has brought a lot of exposure to rugby as a sport and some of its stars. Exposure is supposedly a good thing, and we can assume every rugby star should be happy with this exposure, but this is not exactly the case. The rugby world might not be entirely happy with this documentary, and this is quite understandable, but Netflix was able to make this documentary because it got the permission of the bodies, teams, and people involved. Speaking of the effect of this documentary on rugby, the captain of the English rugby team, Owen Farrell, said, "I'm sure it will be good for the sport. If any of the other Netflix series are anything to go by, they've taken some sports to different levels. Hopefully people can tell their sides to things, in terms of background, upbringing, the things that people do off the field as well as on it." While Netflix was getting ready for this documentary, all the teams involved got notified. As much as they all opened their doors to the Netflix team, it is reported that Italy and Scotland seemed more willing to take part in the documentary. The other teams involved did not seem so keen to participate in this documentary. The reason for this is still unknown, but there's a likelihood that private negative issues around this sport would become public knowledge. Well, this documentary, which was supposedly about a tournament that Ireland won, ended up focusing on Italy, a team that failed to win any match. This raised questions, but the fact that the Italians were more open probably answers your questions. The Italians might have been open, but since the Irish rugby team won this tournament, maybe they should have been the stars of this documentary. Rugby stars had some reservations about the effect of this documentary on the game, but they were not the only ones. Other personalities around the sport also had their reservations. One of them is Warren Gatland. The New Zealander did not exactly have a problem with this documentary, but he didn't seem so comfortable with the fact that the teams that featured in this documentary couldn't take part in the editing. "My understanding is we don't have any editorial rights, and that's a little bit of a concern. The language of the phrases used aren't always appropriate. When you're talking about nations playing each other, the things said in the changing room might not be something that's always believed, but it's a part of getting the best out of your performance. In the past, when we've had the crews that have been involved with Lions and Wales, what's been important is their ability to create a relationship with the players and the coaching team, so it's almost like they become an invisible part of it. Then you find yourself just carrying on with your normal routine because of the trust that you build up with them. So that's the challenge with Netflix. At the moment, my understanding is that we don't have any editorial rights, and that is a little bit of a concern because you want to make sure you can protect yourself. So there's a few things that we need to be conscious of and iron out. The last thing we need is to be bland in the way it comes across, but I'm also conscious that we need to protect ourselves too. That's pretty important." One could say Warren is being a little too personal, but he's not the only one who thinks things could have been done a lot differently. Irons Tad Furlong also thinks the same. While speaking about this documentary capturing details he felt were not supposed to be made public, he compared the approach of this documentary to picking out little details that make one driver better than another in Formula One. "You don't see them talking about engineering. You don't see them talking about little pieces they put on their cars and why they did it. I know Max Verstappen knocked it out. He doesn't fancy it. I'm not sure how much rugby intellectual property I'd like to leak from the group." Ben Morrell, who is the chief executive of the Six Nation, clearly understands Warren's position, but he has also made his position clear. While reacting to concerns of privacy, he said, "It's not like a movie. You don't know what you're going to get. You need to see what storylines unfold. It's unscripted. The more you embrace it and open it, the more you're going to get quality material. The stars are the players and coaches, but you're not quite sure who because you might have an injury, so you need to probably film a lot and then see. There are so many people in the world that do not know enough about about the Six Nations. While Warren is worried about private conversations getting out to the public, Farrell doesn't quite agree. Although it doesn't appear like he's comfortable watching a documentary he is in, he doesn't consider this documentary a big deal. The rugby star, who had seen Netflix documentaries on other sports, feels they've always had cameras around, and they put up content on social media, so there is perhaps not much of a difference. This Netflix documentary might be considered a success by certain folks, but it doesn't appear like rugby fans consider it a good enough documentary. You see, if you don't follow rugby closely, or even watch it at all, you might be satisfied with getting glimpses of matches you never saw or never even knew were played. But actual rugby fans do not want to watch match highlights. They want to see more. Lots of rugby fans in Europe were hoping for a lot of scenes that are not open to rugby fans. Unfortunately, this documentary failed in this area. One could argue that the rugby teams probably did not let the cameras into their dressing room, but it appears this is not the case. Tad Furlong and a couple of other figures in the Irish rugby world made it clear they didn't have a problem with the camera being brought into their dressing room. If this is anything to go by, it's obvious it is not the fault of the teams that this documentary did not capture the things the fans were looking forward to seeing. It is easy to say those in charge of this documentary did not satisfy their viewers because they didn't do their job well. While there's an element of truth in this, it is not entirely up to the creators of this documentary. The reason is, this is not the first time they've come up with a documentary like this. They also created Drive to Survive, which did very well. So it is possible they couldn't do a perfect job because they just did not have access to the materials that they needed. As much as one could easily say rugby fans are not satisfied with the outcome of this documentary, this just might not be the case with non-rugby fans. This documentary was not exactly created for rugby fans. Rather, it was created to market this sport to people who are not interested in it yet. And we can say it succeeded in doing this. Rugby stars might not be comfortable with this documentary, but do you think it did justice to life behind the scenes for rugby stars? Kindly tell us in the comment section below. See you in the next video.